This demonstration video will show the process of creating a simple mesh using the automated meshing tools in SMS. We have opened an SMS project of our demo site. This site is a bridge crossing over the Cimarron River in Oklahoma that has been used in previous demonstrations. It is good practice to start with a simple mesh and add complexity later. We'll begin by creating a new mesh generator type coverage under map data. We'll leave the name of the coverage as mesh generator. Let's rename this coverage to mesh generator simple. Next, we'll create feature arcs that define the boundaries of the mesh. We'll start by using the Create Feature Arc tool to digitize the upstream boundary location. Next, let's create an arc representing the downstream boundary location. Now we'll connect these upstream and downstream boundaries by creating arcs representing the lateral extents of the mesh. These arcs should be located at the edges of the floodplain to include all areas that may become wet. The spacing between vertices determines the resolution of the mesh. We will redistribute the vertices along the arcs. To do this, we'll switch to the Select Feature Arc tool and select all the arcs. Then right-click in the display and select Redistribute Vertices. There are several options for redistributing vertices. Let's choose the Specify Spacing option and enter a value of 50 feet. Next, we need to build polygons by clicking on the Build Polygons shortcut. Now we will assign the mesh generation attributes to the polygon. Using the Select Feature Polygon tool, we'll double-click on the polygon to open the 2D Mesh Polygon Properties dialog. We first specify the mesh type. For this simple mesh, we'll select Paving. This will fill the polygon with triangles beginning at the edges and working inward. To specify an elevation dataset, we'll select the Scatter Set option for the elevation dataset, then select the Scatter Options button. This is the Interpolation Options dialog. We usually just use the Linear option. We'll also need to click on the scatter set we want to specify to use for interpolating the elevations to the mesh nodes. We'll use the Preview Mesh button to view what the mesh will look like with the current options. Based on the mesh preview, we can decide if we need to change any of the mesh options. Note that this dialog has a separate toolbar similar to the one in the main window. These tools can be used to edit or view the mesh without exiting the dialog. For example, we can select the Zoom tool to zoom in and view a detailed area of the mesh. Once we're happy with the mesh, we exit the dialog by clicking OK. We are now ready to generate the mesh. To do so, we right-click on the mesh generator coverage and select Convert Map to 2D Mesh. We could also select Feature Objects from the top menu and click on Map to 2D Mesh. We'll use the right-click method for this demonstration. SMS will prompt us to specify a name for the mesh. We'll call this first mesh Simple Paved Mesh. We've now created a mesh with triangular elements with a resolution of 50 feet. At this point, we should review the mesh to see that it has been created as intended. Another recommended step is to merge the triangles by selecting elements, merge triangles. This will merge triangles into quads as appropriate to reduce the number of elements in the model. This concludes the demonstration.